You're the host of this show. You're an actor. You were an inventor, which I think not a lot of people would know.
Probably not.
And this is a thing you've been doing for a long time.
Yeah, I started back in 11th grade, I think.
Wow.
Mr. Mariner was my chemistry teacher.
Okay.
Love him. He's the one who inspired me to act as well as just follow my heart.
Do what you love.
And so I would draw in my chemistry book, like, all these wacky inventions, and I'd be like, how do I do this? And he would tell me how to do it or kind of, like, put me in the right direction. Well, that, you know, going forward, I started just getting that book and making some of these products. And I have 5 patents right now. I just got my 5th one yesterday.
Do we have one of your inventions?
All
right, talk these through real quick. Explain these before I show them to people.
Okay, so I got, during the Twilight, you guys saw Twilight, right?
Yeah.
All the girls are like, yeah!
Yes.
What's that one?
I also saw it. I also saw Twilight.
And you went,
yeah!
No. I didn't have to.
Thank you. That was internal.
What I was doing inside.
So during those, we had a lot of paparazzi days, and, you know, people took pictures of me wearing one of those eye masks that was, like, purple.
Like velour. On an airplane?
On an airplane.
Okay, gotcha.
I'm like, this is not action hero-like. This is not very cool. So then I started wearing regular sunglasses, and the light would just come through when you have these day flights to New York. So I'm like, why can't I solve that problem and make sunglasses that are blacked out? So I made blackout bands.
Blackout? So these are...
You just can't see.
Wow. So you can't see anything right now, but you look like a cool cat.
Are you doing something? Should I say...
I'm not doing anything.
Okay. No. Your turn.
All right. Wow, you really can't see anything. You know what? did you ever have any inventions that didn't work?
Yeah, a lot. I love chemistry, so I would use my chemistry set and make a lot of fires.
Okay. And fire had already been invented.
What?
Yeah,
is there a patent?
Yeah.
Is there a patent on fire? And who owns that? And
right.
Did they reinvent it?
Yeah, that's a good
point.
Because you have to
pay every 70 years, 20 years, whatever. But one of my first ones was called the car seat cardio.
Okay.
It was my CSC invention. It was a car seat that I put on my car, and I had, like, workout bands underneath, so you're, like, driving.
Oh, so it's to work out while you're driving.
Well, yeah, of course. That's safe.
It's a death trap, yeah.
Well, I mean, you got to get it in when you can. even the headrest, like, you have these, like, L1s, and, like, you hit the button, it comes down like this. And then, you know, at the gym, those ones, whatever
right.
that is.
So you would do that while you were driving.
And... It looks so creepy when I'm at a stoplight. I'm like...
Yeah. That's great. I mean,
it's so great.
I'd love to get in on the ground floor of that one. You animal lover. You grew up on a farm. You've done work with PETA.
Yeah.
So you grew up, and so you were surrounded by animals when you were young?
I love animals. I used to, when I lived in Iowa, we have our family farm there in Des Moines, and we had tons of, like, pigs and cows.
Mm-hmm.
And my mom, we had tons of boys. So what I loved to do when I was young was just water the pigs. And that consisted of standing by the pig pen for 8 hours. And then I loved rain or shine, snow or shine, them just shaking their mud on me.
Okay.
And I would be covered. And I was like, hey, like, giddy little boy. And I'd go inside and get a nice little bubble bath. But the great thing is I named all those pigs.
You named
and
hundreds
cows
of pigs?
And cats who I thought I used to talk to. I used to think I was Mowgli. Because I'd go like,
wow.
Creepy, I know.
Yeah.
But I'd always have, like, milk, and I always thought I was, like, communicating with them, like Dr. Doolittle.
Uh-huh.
But they liked the milk.
Gotcha. Oh, was that hard for you when you realized that their attention wasn't actually that you were communicating with them, that they just wanted milk?
What do you mean I was not communicating?
This is harder than telling you.
I was communicating.
I don't even know what to tell you. Oh, my goodness. Kellan Lutz, everybody!